When a patient calls into Houston Methodist CPAM, I assure the patient they've reached the right department. I then gather the information that is needed to assist the patient, and I hand it off to our patient service liaison.
When an artist calls into the artist care line, we find out exactly what the illness or symptoms are. We find out if there is an injury, and then we work to match the potential patient with the best provider here at Houston Methodist. Oftentimes, artists travel. We anticipate many artists will be coming to Houston for performances, and it's very reassuring to have a health advocate for those who are locals or whether they come in from any part of the world. Many times we have artists who call with orthopedic injuries. It could be a violinist, perhaps, who is experiencing an injury to their fingers or to their hand. We also see ballet performers.
One of my goals when I began taking care of the Houston Ballet, and with the incredible involvement of the Center for Performing Arts Medicine at Houston Methodist, was to bring the healthcare for the ballet and the ballet dancers up to the same level as other professional sports teams in Houston. Because they're not just artists, they're also incredible elite level athletes. In addition, we've been able to do some research studies that have looked at injury prevention in ballet dancers and have been able to use those results to influence and decrease our injury rates at the Houston Ballet.
The Artist Card program is unique to Houston Methodist. It's a way for artists to pre-register themselves within our system, and we can take special attention in making sure that they see the right physician or therapist that's familiar with their art form and familiar with getting artists back in shape, back on stage, and continuing to keep them well. Now, this is a free program, and when you register online on our website, you also receive this nice artist card that signifies that you're a member of our program. On it, it has reminder phone numbers, especially of our CPAM liaison, who will help triage your condition to the right physician or therapist to make sure you receive the best care.
As a performing artist, especially as an opera singer, we have to use our entire body throughout each and every performance. So being at our tip-top shape is always most important. To have people that understand and know exactly where we come from, what we need, and how to address those issues in an expedited and very comfortable manner is something that's really unparalleled. I thank all of the people at Houston Methodist. This program is needed for so many performers, and I'm glad that I happen to be a recipient of such wonderful care.
Here at the Texas Voice Center, we see a lot of artists that are struggling with their voices. Whether they're acute issues right before a performance or chronic issues that have been going on for months. When we treat a patient, we have to ensure that we're considering their entire career as opposed to just the here and now. Because hopefully after we get over whatever their issue is that they're coming in for, they're gonna be performing for the next 10, 15, 20 years. So we make sure that we're not short-sighted in our treatment plans. When we see performers in the office, we try to do a comprehensive exam. That'll often include a video stroboscopy, which is a scope so we can look at their vocal cords to really find out what's happening. In addition to that, we find out what the history of their voice problems are, when they've had problems, what makes it worse, what makes it better. That way we're better able to formulate a plan to help them both in the here and now and in the future.
Dr. DeBakey described our hospital as a hospital with a soul. We feel by partnering with the arts community, we are bringing performing arts into the hospital. Houston Methodist has been serving the needs of our community for over 100 years. We feel we have a responsibility to provide high quality care to those in need, regardless of their circumstances. Dr. Stasny asked us to see all performing artists in need, with insurance or without, and all the doctors pledged to do so.
I know in my 45 years I've been injured. I've had, you know, voice problems and all the things that actors and dancers and singers and crew has to deal with on a regular basis. Houston Methodist, knowing that they're there for us, for the artists, it's a great burden off of all of our backs.
One thing I think that's important for any doctor that's treating a performing artist is to really understand the nuances and the special requirements and needs that the performing artist may have. A good example may be, let's say, an opera singer that comes into the emergency department that has a laryngitis or just getting over a cold or an upper respiratory viral infection, or maybe a little vocal cord strain from performance. That person has unique needs in the sense that they may be performing that evening. So our ability to recognize that case early on in their treatment course and expedite that care is ultimately going to determine that patient's outcome.
The field of artist health is growing. We're seeing more and more fellowships and internships in performing arts medicine. We're seeing organizations like PAMA, the Performing Arts Medicine Association. So at Methodist, now that we have 25 years of experience under our belt, we hope that we'll continue to help lead medicine and artist health around the world.